Okay, class, in the previous lesson, we looked at the positive role played by transport sector. Now let us look at problems, challenges affecting transport sector. Number one, inadequate capital. Most of the countries in the world, especially our African countries, do not have enough capital in terms of money, for example, to construct better airports, better roads, better ports, and railway lines. These infrastructures are very expensive. Two, natural barriers. For example, forests, deserts, lakes, steep relief, etc. These ones make it more expensive to construct transport networks. For example, roads. It is not easy to construct a road across a lake. It is almost impossible. And it takes more money also to construct an airport, or almost impossible, on steep slopes. Next, political situation, political instability. Most of our African countries, for example, are ever involved in wars, and they spend much of their money on buying guns and firearms compared to the money they spend on improving and maintaining transport networks. Climate, for example, heavy rainfall and floods make roads muddy and slippery, and fog may also disturb air transport, causing poor visibility. Mass wasting and landslides also affect roads in mountainous areas. They even make some of the roads impassable. Low technology causes overdependence on imported labor, and this one will also finally lead to profit repatriation. After importing labor or importing people with high technology to work on roads, airports, railway lines, most of the money they earn, they end up taking it to their home countries, and a problem of profit repatriation occurs. Lack of enough labor force. Enough labor force involves skilled labor, same skilled labor, and unskilled labor to work on roads, to construct airports, to construct railway lines, etc. Poor drainage. Some areas are waterlogged. They contain swamps and wetlands, which makes it expensive and almost impossible to construct transport networks like roads. Negative government policies. Some countries and their governments don't have a positive attitude towards developing transport networks. They don't give a priority, a first chance, the development of roads, airports. They are involved in other activities. Corruption and embezzlement of funds allocated to road construction, airport construction, is also another big problem affecting the development of road transport. Presence of waterfalls and rapids along rivers also discourage water transport, because if there are steep cliffs or waterfalls along the river, boats will not sail from one side of the river to another, or from the source to the mouth. How can we improve transport? How? In short, how can we solve the problems we have seen? ensuring political stability, containerization of the ports and harbors for effective handling of goods and reduce delays. Government policies should be positive towards construction of better infrastructures. They allocate a big budget to construction of roads, airports, etc. And there should be construction of bridges across rivers to connect different areas, draining swamps for road construction. The waterlogged swamps should be drained. Improving engineering technology and having schools in particular countries that train engineers who will help in constructing roads, airports, railway lines, instead of depending on foreign labor. There are very many solutions you can suggest. Thank you.